Hello students, this is Dr. Ranjini, Assistant Professor in Biotechnology. Welcome to Practical Sessions in Microbial Technology. Today in this session, we learn about biotechnological importance of few microorganisms which are included in your syllabus. First, we learn about the biotechnological importance of E. coli. It is otherwise called as Escherichia coli. Is crucial in modern biotechnology. Scientists are using this microorganism to store DNA sequences from other organisms to produce proteins of our interest or to test the protein function. There are a large number of E. coli strains, like subtypes, with the diverse characteristics. Most are harmless to human being, including the strains like strain B and strain K12. These are used routinely for laboratory work. However, in addition to this harmless strains, there are also harmful strains. The culturing of the E. coli is very easy, and this grows very fast. Scientists first chose to work with E. coli because it was easy and fast to grow in vitro condition, under laboratory condition. There are several features which make it easy to culture under laboratory condition. It likes to grow in warm condition, but not too warm, because E. coli is a gut bacterium. It grows best at body temperature, at around 37.4 degrees centigrade. This is an easy temperature for scientists to work with in the laboratory. E. coli can obtain energy from wide variety of substrates. In its natural environment, for example, in gut, it consumes digested foodstuffs. In laboratory, E. coli can be fed very easily and cheaply with the very cheap raw materials. It can grow with or without oxygen. In gut, E. coli grows anaerobically in the absence of oxygen. However, unlike some anaerobic bacteria, E. coli also grow well in aerobic environment, such as our culture conical flask in laboratory condition. It grows fast under ideal conditions. This can, E. coli can double at every 20 minutes. At that rate, it would be possible to produce millions of E. coli cells from one parent cell within about 6.5 to 7 hours. Fast growth means that means when it grows fastly, the experiments can be done quickly, and at the same time, the experiment can be reproduced for the same result. So that's why E. coli will be used. So this microorganism is the first choice for molecular cloning. Since the technique of molecular cloning, E. coli has been used as a host for desired DNA sequences. In 1973, scientists Boyer and Cohen showed for the first time that two short pieces of bacterial DNA could be cut and pasted together and returned to the E. coli. So recombinant DNA technology is very easy with E. coli strain. And they went on to show that DNA from other species, such as frogs, could also be introduced into E. coli. So like this, E. coli will be used in recombinant DNA technology for inserting the gene of our interest. And that's why it became the bacterium of choice for virtually for all molecular cloning experiment. Today, E. coli is used in labs worldwide as a host for foreign DNA sequences and their protein products. Next, we will move on to the biotechnological importance of yeast. Yeast have been exploited by mankind for thousands of years for food and fermentation processes. Traditionally, the yeast has been used for the production of alcohol beverages, biomass, and even for glycerol. Saccharomyces cerevisiae has been described as mankind's most domesticated organism and still widely exploited yeast species in industry, that is for the large scale production today. The number of yeast species described so far is about 1,500, and only about dozen is used in large scale production in industry. Some about 70 to 80 species have been shown to possess potential value for biotechnology. Beyond the classical applications, modern applications of yeast have been greatly expanded, especially Saccharomyces cerevisiae and other non-Saccharomyces yeasts today are increasingly used for the heterologous production of enzymes and pharmaceutical proteins. Yeasts have important roles in environmental applications such as bioremediation and removal of heavy metals from wastewater. Yeasts are also used in agriculture for biocontrol mechanism. It is used as a biocontrol agent. Several chemicals can be produced using yeast as a biocatalyst. Saccharomyces cerevisiae is largest cultivated organism so far, having in mind diversity and potential of all yeast species. The cultivation and utilization of Saccharomyces cerevisiae, that is Saccharomyces yeast, are still at the tip of the iceberg, and there is a vast potential yet to be discovered for the production of valuable products using Saccharomyces and non-Saccharomyces yeasts. That is regarding the biotechnological importance of yeast. Next, we will move on to the biotechnological importance of cyanobacteria, that is spirulina. Spirulina, as I told, it's blue-green algae, is well recognized as a potential food supplement for human being because of its high protein content. It contains about 65 to 70% of dry weight of the protein. In addition to this percentage of proteins, spirulina also has vitamins and minerals. In addition to its high protein level, spirulina cells also contain significant amount of pigments like phycocyanin, which is an antioxidant that is used as an ingredient in various products developed by cosmetic and even in pharmaceutical industries. Spirulina cells also produce sulfolipids that have been reported to exert inhibitory effects on the virus, that is herpes simplex type 1 virus. Spirulina is able to synthesize polyunsaturated fatty acids such as glycerolipid, that is gamma linolenic acid. This spirulina is a self-pH elevating microorganism rich in protein, and this will be consumed in the form of powders, biscuits, and many sweets will be made from this spirulina. And this spirulina is gaining more importance nowadays, and consumption of this spirulina will not be having any other contamination because it elevates the pH to about 10.5 to 11. So at this pH, most of the microorganisms will feel difficulty to grow in this ionic strength. So in this session, we learned the biotechnological importance of few microorganisms which are included in your practical syllabus. I hope you understood this session. Thank you.